Hi, this is Shoptalk. I'm Rieta Nwako Trillo. For Catholics, part of their spiritual journey is joining pilgrimages to places that have significance to the faith. This Monday Thursday, we'll talk about pilgrimage experiences to the Holy Land and Marian apparition sites. In the first segment, we're joined by Maan, Tolentino, director at MDM Classic Travel. Maan has been to the Holy Land numerous times because of her work, but today she'll tell us about her personal favorites among the sites within the Holy Land. Hello, Maan, and thanks for coming on the show.
Hi, Ria. Thanks for the invitation.
Okay, you've been to the Holy Land many times. How many times?
Yeah, I can't count because it's been, well, I reveal my age, maybe 3 decades of travel. Yeah, so maybe more than a dozen times.
Okay, so if you've been there more than a dozen times, there obviously is something that keeps drawing you back there.
Uh-huh. Well, of course, I was there in the past because I was assisting my dad. Mm-hmm. You know, he brings pilgrims to the Holy Land and other holy places. And, of course, it's something that I really wanted because pilgrimage is a different experience.
It's not your ordinary vacation.
It's not a lifestyle, the lifestyle stuff, you know, because it also fulfills you spiritually.
Okay, let's talk about the actual places that you've been to, right? Tell me first about the pit where Jesus was said to have been thrown after his scourging.
You know, it was a couple of visits after I saw that. Mm-hmm. You know, they didn't show that to us for when I started visiting Holy Land. It touched me because I found out that Jesus was thrown in a pit, you know, after he was jailed. And you can see the blood, you know, dried blood, and which people believe that
is that it right there?
Yeah.
All right.
And the first time I saw it and touched it, you know, I cried. Mm-hmm. You know that feeling of awe and respect, and it's more than joy. So I said, oh, my God. It's really awesome, and I could never forget that.
Yeah, I mean, I have several friends who've been to the Holy Land, mm-hmm. and they say even just when you get off the plane, the whole place has a completely different energy of its own. Did you feel
correct,
that?
Correct. You got the word, energy. And, you know, besides the physical look, because mm-hmm. you see white all over, you know, can you imagine it's where Jesus used to walk,
right.
where the saints and the apostles used to walk, you know, it's history. Besides, you know.
So much more.
Yeah.
Exactly. All right. What else are your other favorite places in the Holy Land?
I particularly like the milk grotto.
Okay.
You know, sometimes it's difficult to go in because they close early, and usually we come from the Church of the Nativity, and usually there's a long line, so we run going to the milk grotto. It's called the milk grotto because it is believed that the Holy Family hid there during the time that they wanted to slaughter the innocents.
Okay.
And it was where the Blessed Mother nursed Jesus. So it was believed that when she was nursing Jesus, a few drops of the milk fell down. Mm-hmm. So you will see the cave, which has some powdery white mm-hmm. in the cave. So some people try to scratch it, and the Franciscans sometimes give away the powder for mothers who want to bear children, or for people who are sick.
Right. That's beautiful. What did you feel personally when you went there?
Amazed. Yeah, I was amazed. And it was only in this place that you will see a painting of Mama Mary nursing Jesus.
Right, that's not an image you see often.
Yeah, it's not common.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And, okay, what about the Temple Mount?
I particularly was interested there because... it is sacred to many religions.
That's right. You know, the three major faiths of the world all hold
yes.
this very, you know, as a very revered site.
Yeah. It's sacred to the Christians because, and the Jews, this was where Abraham wanted to sacrifice Isaac. at the same time, it is believed that it was part of the Second Temple during the time of Christ. And third, for the Muslims, they believe that Muhammad ascended up from that Temple Mount. So one thing interesting with Holy Land is, you know, I'm a Christian, a Catholic. When you go there, you will see several religions, all respecting a certain place, the same place that all religions, you know, that other religions also respect. Something interesting.
So when you actually go there, you're basically just looking at ruins, am I right?
No, not everything is ruined.
Okay, so what is left remaining there?
Actually, they built churches over.
Okay.
Churches or prayer places. For example, when you go to Church of Nativity, I was surprised. I thought it was a Catholic place. No, it was Greek Orthodox.
Oh,
and okay. Beside the Church of Nativity, there's the Church of St. Catherine, which is the Catholic side, guarded by the Franciscans.
And this is all like within the same area, within the area of the temple now.
Yes.
Okay.
Different religions are in charge of several sacred places.
What's it like, though, when you see Jews, Christians, Catholics, and Muslims sort of all praying in the same area?
Well, the first time I was surprised. I couldn't really understand that this was an Armenian place. There are different quarters in Old Jerusalem. You have the Christian quarter, the Muslim, Armenian, and I forgot the other one, the Jewish area. Just tells us that we're all brothers and sisters.
Right.
Yeah. We believe in one Lord, but, you know, in different ways.
Exactly. That must be a really beautiful thing to see, though. You know, at least in this part of Israel, people can pray in their own way.
Yes.
And peacefully and, you know, respectfully.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But, I mean, historically, we are saying that those places are where these things happened. But then, can they actually confirm that? Or is that something you take on faith as well?
Most of the places, they will say that more or less it happened here.
Okay.
But there are certain spots where they will tell you that Jesus really walked here.
Exactly.
But most are really beliefs based on faith.
Right.
But more or less, in that area.
Yeah.
Even when he was born, it's not exactly there, but more or less it's
in that area. But there must be something to it, because when people go there, they always say they feel something.
Yes,
right?
Correct.
Right.
You're right.
Okay, what about away from the Holy Land now? You've also been to Bruges, and there's a special place there as well.
Yes. Actually, I didn't know that. You know, we just wanted to visit with a friend, and we wanted to visit because it's a UNESCO heritage site. Then when I was looking at the internet, I found out that the Holy Blood of Jesus was there, the relic.
And that's what we're looking at?
Yes.
Okay.
And It was a miracle that I was able to see it, because during the time they really do not bring it out. But I had no choice. That was the only schedule. And so we went there. We were almost late for Mass. We didn't want to let people in because there are mostly tourists going in.
Mm-hmm.
Then all of a sudden after Mass, it was a good thing I stayed and we prayed. They brought it out.
They just so happened to bring it up when you stayed after Mass.
Yes.
Okay.
It was not, there was a schedule. I even wrote the parish priest. And he said it couldn't, you know, come out during that day.
Oh, you really wanted to see it then.
Yes, for me it was a gift. It was a blessing.
Right. And it's just blood in a
vial? It's in a vial.
Okay.
Yeah, it's in a vial. You know, during the olden times, there was no European spelling for a year. There was the Holy Roman Empire, etc. So usually the relics from the saints, they're given to princes and, you know, the monarchy.
And it's just, what did you feel when you saw this, the blood of
Again,
Christ?
Again, I kind of cried. You know, when you feel awed and everything, you know. Because it was a surprise that we saw it.
Yeah, I'm sure it can be really
able to
overwhelming.
The relic, yeah.
Okay, what tips do you have for people traveling to the Holy Land or pilgrimages in general?
Mm-hmm. Well, through the years, I'd say that whenever you go to a pilgrimage, it's not really a vacation per se. I think you should prepare for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, prepare spiritually. If you're a Catholic like me, maybe you'd like to receive the sacraments before.
Mm-hmm.
Not everything is rosy. You know, sometimes people go on a pilgrimage and then they get upset with little stuff and they really get irritated and they forget that they're going to a pilgrimage.
Right. And it can ruin the whole experience.
Yes, sometimes there are messages that the Lord tries to send to you.
Right. Yeah. What about, how did it change your faith in general? How did the pilgrimages change your life?
Of course, feeling stronger, especially when you see people that you bring there also regain faith or belief because you were able to bring them there. And, of course, it widens your perspective. Travel always widens one's perspective.
Very true. Your travels have actually taken you also to Pope John Paul II, and you were actually able to receive communion from him.
Yes, that was one of the highlights of our, travel.
Was this in the Holy Land or in the Vatican?
No, in the Vatican. It was Urbi et Urbi during Easter. And my dad didn't tell me that you were going to receive communion. And right now, I was really thinking, oh my God, he's going to be beatified.
Exactly.
I received communion from a saint. Yeah, so truly unforgettable.
Right, right. And what pilgrimages inspire you to this day? Or which pilgrimages would you still want to do that you haven't already done?
Besides the Holy Land, of course, you have other holy places. The Marian pilgrimage, something very close to our heart. There's so many miracles that the Blessed Mother has, given us.
Mm-hmm.
From Our Lady of Lourdes, Fatima, and all over Europe.
That's great, because my next guest is going to talk about
correct.
That. But before I let you go, I understand you're organizing a trip to the Holy Land, I think, later this year. Tell us about that.
We're in the Holy Land this coming Holy Week. After that, this May, end of May, May 28th, we have a trip. And after May, we'll be having again about two groups at the end of the year.
Okay, around November.
Plus, that's for Holy Land and also Europe.
What would be included?
About September, October.
Okay, what would be included in those tours and how many days long is it?
Holy Land is usually around, including travel time, around 8 to 10 days for Holy Land. For Europe, for the Marian pilgrimage or other pilgrimages, usually it's about 18 days.
Oh, longer. A bit longer.
Yeah, because it's farther.
That's right. Well, thank you so much, Maan, for telling us all about your wonderful experiences.
Yes, thank you for your
Holy Land is definitely on my list of places to travel.
Yeah, don't forget to join us.
I hope so. Mm-hmm. Thank you again so much.
Okay.
We're taking a short break now. Keep it here. Shop Talk. We'll be right back.